2012.
And welcome to the first political debate of 4029 News. Today we're focusing on State House 84 race between incumbent Charlie Collins and his Democratic challenger, Adela Gray. Here are the rules for our debate. The candidates will have 1 minute to respond to the questions. So first, let's get to know our candidates. Mrs. Gray, let's start with you.
Yes, my name is Adela Gray. I have been a resident of Fayetteville for almost 40 years. We'll be 40 next year. I'm originally from Kentucky. Married an Arkansan, have been here since 64. I have been on the city council for 6 years in the city of Fayetteville. I'm a lifelong educator. I was a school counselor in Springdale for the last 13 years of my working life. And so I have thoroughly enjoyed being on the city council and look forward to going to the House legislature.
Okay, Mr. Collins, your turn.
My name is Charlie Collins, and I graduated from the U.S. Naval Academy in 1985 and married my wife, Leanne, later that year. After serving in the Navy and beginning my business career at Procter & Gamble, we were transferred to Fayetteville and raised our four kids, including triplets here. My older daughter is a sophomore at the University of Arkansas. My triplet daughter just started as a midshipman at the U.S. Merchant Marine Academy in Kings Point, New York, and my two boys are seniors at Fayetteville High School. If I was to sum up why I enjoy being in the legislature and what I think I can help do here, it's improving the life of all Arkansans. And the number one thing we need to do to continue to improve the quality of life here is turn our state into a good jobs magnet. Step one of my plan is reducing the income tax, the tax on work. I look forward to talking more about that today.
Okay, thank you for introducing yourselves. Now let's turn to why you're running for State House 84, of course, which covers Fayetteville. So Mr. Collins, tell us why you're running for another term.
As I mentioned earlier, I think it's imperative that in Arkansas we improve our quality of life. And if you look at a lot of measures like median incomes or percentage of our residents who are college graduates or lots of other measures, what we find is decade after decade, we're near the bottom of the 50 state rankings in those categories. I've talked to thousands and thousands of Arkansans, and frankly, there's nothing wrong with us. And I think that we can do some things in the way we go to market that will change how our quality of life here is in our state. Number one is turning our state into a good jobs magnet. The Arkansas income tax is higher than all the states that surround us, so reducing that on workers makes our workers more competitive with workers in states like Louisiana and Texas and Missouri, and that'll help improve the quality of life of Arkansas.
Okay, Mr. Collins, thank you. Now to your challenger, Mrs. Gray, why are you running for the seat?
I'm running for the seat simply because I am a very strong supporter of our current governor, Governor BB. I feel that he has, in his 6 years, done many things to improve the life of Arkansans. And he only has 2 years left, and I want to be there to help him. First of all, education. That is number one for Governor BB, and it's number one for me. I think that improving education for all Arkansans, whether it's technical school or community college, improving the education, that is the link to more jobs for Arkansas. We've never ever had anyone turn down Arkansas to come here and create jobs simply because of taxes. They've not come here simply because we did not have the educated workforce.
Okay, thank you. Now, both of you have degrees from universities. You've developed programs and businesses to help our community. Now, Mrs. Gray, talk to us about how you view education and the job market.
The way I view education and the job market, they go together very tightly. I think that we all know that the more education you have, the more apt you are to make a good living and have a good quality of life. I feel that education is the secret to our getting more jobs in Arkansas. I know that there are many young men and women who, for one reason or another, drop out of working on their bachelor's degree. And I was just reading a great article about the five of our institutions, as well as the chambers of commerce and our Northwest Arkansas Council, who are working together to create a situation where anyone who has done some work on a bachelor's degree can call one of these institutions, and they will be given information about how they can come back and finish their education.
Okay, Mrs. Gray, thank you. Now, Mr. Collins, same question to you. Talk to us about how you view education and the jobs market.
Education is critical to improving jobs, especially over the long term in Arkansas. And while I think that lowering the income tax is step one, there's no question that improving education is the long-term solution to great long-term job growth in Arkansas. And I'm a big supporter of education. In fact, when Fayetteville High School's advanced placement training program was canceled, the Fayetteville program administrator actually called me to say, we've got a real problem here. And we were able to get that program reinstituted and refunded so that our kids will be able to take the kind of preparatory courses they need to do well on the ACT test and select the college of their choice. Education's key. We need to look at it in multiple facets, and we need to think real hard about expanding parental choice. Expanding parental choice includes things like charter schools and other options. All of these things will help improve education in Arkansas, the linchpin to the future of our state.
Okay, Mr. Collins, thank you. Now, you both supported ideas that have failed. Mr. Collins, open carry, and Mrs. Gray, the smoking ban in Fayetteville bars. Do you still support these views now that they've been voted down? Mr. Collins, we'll start with you.
The bill that I proposed was to expand concealed carry on college campuses with professors and full-time faculty members only. So it would exclude any students from participation. And the reason I introduced this bill is because we've got a real problem in our country. Because college campuses are no-fire zones, crazies and killers are choosing these places over and over again. Just last month in Texas, six people were shot, three of them killed. And I believe that if we allow concealed carry permit holders, who are full-time faculty at colleges in Arkansas, to carry their weapons, that will actually reduce the number of deaths in our state, and yes, I've not given up on that opportunity.
Okay, thank you. Now, Mrs. Gray, your response to the failed smoking ban.
Well, that was a huge disappointment, and of course, we had to have a super majority. We did have a simple majority, but yes, I do feel very strongly that this is an important bill for our state. You know, there are many conventions that won't even come to our state. The American Heart Association, the American Lung Association, they will not even consider coming to our state because we are a smoking state. Until we get smoking banned in the majority of the bars in our state, we will not be able to recruit those folks. The other main reason that I'm so against this, well, I have a personal reason. My family, I had issues with my father, who was a long-term smoker. But the other thing is, it so greatly increases our health expense. And I think as long as we're looking to get the most we can out of our healthcare dollars, we need to look at things that are going to help cut. Thank you.
Okay, thank both of you.